Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. Now, when you talk about chemistry, you can't get too deep into the topic without encountering an idea called effective nuclear charge. And it's very closely related to the idea of valence electrons. So let's quickly recap what we know about an atom. We know we have a nucleus, and in this nucleus we have our protons, we have our neutrons, and we have these shells, and there are these some of these shells are non-valence shells. Sometimes these are called shielding shells, and that term will come back again. Of course, we have electrons in these shells, and then we have the valence shell, which has its own electrons. So when we talk about effective nuclear charge, or ZEF, we're referring to the net positive charge that is attracting our valence electrons. Great. Okay, well, this is going to be a numerical value, and as a numerical value, we can calculate it with an equation. ZEF, which is effective nuclear charge, equals Z minus S. Okay, well, what are these two things? Z is equal to the number of protons that we have in the atom. And this, as it turns out, is simply equal to the atomic number. S is equal to the number of shielding electrons. That is, the number of electrons in our non-valence or shielding shells. Now, there's an important idea here. If the atom is neutral, and that is almost always the case in organic chemistry, if the atom is neutral, then the number of protons in our molecule is equal to the number of total electrons in our atom. If it's neutral, protons and electrons have to be equal. So this helps us out quite a bit. So let's fix our equation. Effective nuclear charge equals Z minus S, and we can say this is the same as, since Z is equal to the total number of electrons, our equation becomes total number of electrons minus the shielding electrons. And what this comes out to be is, it's simply the total electrons take away the shielding electrons, leaves us our valence electrons. So that's what effective nuclear charge is. It equals our number of valence electrons. Okay, well, how do we figure out that? We know how to figure out that, because that's simply equal to the group number. It's in this snippet of a periodic table that I have on the screen, our group numbers, 1, 2, going across 3 through 8. And even if our group numbers are numbered differently, where this would be 1, 2, and when we pick up with this 3, it'd be 13, 14, 15. It's simply our group number take away the tens place. So what is the effective nuclear charge for carbon? It's the group number, 4. So the effective nuclear charge for carbon is 4, same as the number of valence electrons, same as the group number. What's the effective nuclear charge for oxygen? Well, it's the same as the group number, same as the valence electrons, it's 6. So we can very quickly, with a periodic table, determine what the effective nuclear charge is for a neutral atom.